Hey guys, gonna be doing some Wanderer gameplay here today on North America's version of Lost Saga. Wanderer, known as Nangin for other servers and versions of Lost Saga. A really good character here. Very efficient, very great, very diverse set of tools available to him. And he can really pile on the damage. He can really shut down a lot of cheesy kind of tactics. And he really pays off in the long run. And there's some lag on DJ there. I don't want to fool with him too much. There we go. No, not quite. Oh no. Whoa. Alright, hit that off. Alright, hit him down. Almost hit him down. Oh, dude, what is going on, DJ? If you're gonna follow me around, at least not lag. Please, please. Alright, let's get full time here in the back. Oh man, I walked right into that basic. Oh no, not the Kali trinket. Oh man, I'm almost dead now. That sucks. Oh, whoa, that was close. Ooh, okay. I want to hang out until I get my skills ready. That's what I want to do. Okay, let's get DJ here. Oh, man. That was really close. Ooh, look out. Okay. Ah! Weapon skill, go! Keep it really simple here. I don't need to do any, like, hold the airs or anything. He's jumping a lot, so that armor is really going to pay off. Ah! Of course, it does mess up your juggle if you're not on the fringe of it, so keep that in mind if you're trying to use the armor skill to really pile in the damage on your follow-ups with your basics. Because you'll need to be at max range to really make it work really well. Also, don't remember that you have inputs to keep yourself a little bit safer, which can be really useful. Oh no! Oh, dude, you ruined my kill. Okay. Oh no, not the weapon skill! Please no trinket! Please no trinket! Oh, Titan armor. Hit him in the back. I don't know what Lemur's doing. What is it? Hit the guy hitting you, dude. Some people, they just go for you just blindly. Like, you know, the Wanderer. So, doing okay here so far. Almost got an edge there. I might have got an edge there. That would have been nice if I did. Get SPO. Oh no! There's my stalker. Got plenty of stalkers in this room so far. Good double hits there. Oh man, look at that 19 hit combo. That's right, DJ's lagging. Alright, get away from me, DJ. You're lagging too much, bro. I wanna have fun. I don't wanna fight someone lagging real bad. Go hit other people. Alright. No, he's gonna follow me. Alright, oh. Alright, got him off there. That was a good setup. Let's use this weapon skill, getting surrounded too much. Oh, he actually went off the edge there. Alright, let's pop this armor, because he's going to be jumping a little bit. Oh no, look out, weapon skill! Kali weapon skill. Uh-oh. Let's go ahead and pop this range thing here. Now he can't hit me with basics. Or, well, maybe he can. I don't know. Okay, I guess I just, you know, had to mash for that kill there. That was pretty whack, but it worked. Oh, Flair's using the Hoar Ring. I thought he was using Nangin, but apparently not. Oh, there comes DJ again. Got him out of the air. Good anti-air once again. There we go. Good gap closer. Good gap closer, but, you know, I gotta deal with Flair hitting me in the back now. And probably this Nangin trying to kill me too while he's getting hit in the back. It's just a back party here. Oh, alright for that armor there. That's awesome. Alright, yeah, I got too many stalkers. Too many stalkers. I gotta get a little bit of freedom here. Alright. Good job, whoever that was. Oh no! Oh, I'm dead! And my weapon skill is almost ready too. That's too unfortunate. Hopefully, I spawn nearby enough. Flair's gonna use it and take away my kills. Alright. Oh, too slow. Let's go ahead and back off. Alright, he's blocking too much. Had to do it. Oh, didn't get the follow-up, though. That'll make him block less, hopefully, though. He did use his trinket there. Hit Lemur. Whoa, look out for the Monkey King. Good knockdown on the little jump attack, too, for anti-air. That really helps out to get, like, people down on the ground and let them kind of struggle to recover quickly with, like, headbands and all that. Oh, that was really close. Oh, I probably should be using the input more off these basics, like, you know, but I gotta get used to it. It's kind of like a trickier set of inputs. You gotta change by the direction you're going. Let's just stay down for this one. Almost. Oh! Kinda got something there. Oh, I tried to get the anti-air. Getting in a pincer spot here. Oh, that could have been a lot worse than what it was. Oh, hit him down at least. Let's go and pop this helmet, and he'll be completely shut down with his range. That other guy will too. Like, I'm A-OK now with range attacks. No luck on that. Let's go ahead and do some tricky inputs here. Could be using the weapon skill on this guy. Alright. Get some juggling going. Gap closing. Easy damage. Easy. This character is really easy to use. Uh-oh. This could be bad. Okay, a lot of people around here. There we go. That should be really nice. Keep it simple. Just kill him without launching him. Because, you know, people can recover with, like, headbands and stuff. Almost edged him. Let's go ahead and pop this armor when I get the chance. That would be nice. Got stalkers again. Gotta watch out. So yeah, you gotta be very far back if you're gonna get that armor skill to really work out nicely for you. Oh no, that missed! Amazing! Oh, nice edge! Beautiful edge, beautiful edge. Nice job, player. That wall ring is pretty tough to fight. So let's see, who do we got here? DJ? Kinda hit him. Use the counter once in a while? It didn't work out too well there. Oh my gosh, what just hit me? I think it was that Kali weapon skill. Almost got that whole D. Almost. So close. So let's try to get up here, up in here. No turning with your back, player. No Viking shields. No Viking shield zone. Oh! Look out. Ah, no jumping. Oh, Yumi. Hit her again. If you can time your whole D, it can be really, really good. It can be so good. It can shut down a lot of cheesy things in the game. Oh no, choo-choo! Oh! Hopefully I get my helmet ready soon. That was really close to edging myself. Oh, here comes my stalker. Oh, they did get me. Okay. Go stalk Flare a little bit, guys. Got a little hit there. Thank you for kind of saving me there. Bombastic, Mr. Bombastic, out of Fantastic. A little bit of something there. Let's go ahead and pop this armor. That should keep me a little bit safe. Pop the helmet. Oh no! This could hurt. Woo! Woo! Anti-air! Anti-air for you. Just do some naked melee. Hopefully, Flair doesn't overtake us in this little bit of time. He's over there. I can see him. Oh, nice counter there, but... Oh, hey, I got some stuff here. Medals and all good kind of stuff. So yeah, there I am with that nice blindfold. He's a cool-looking character. So let's see, how did we do? I think Flair was our main competition. Yep, we actually won! Barely beat out Flair, so good stuff here so far. So we might go ahead and replace one or two gears, guys, and hopefully that'll work out for the next round. So let's do one more with Nangin, aka Wanderer here, guys. Gonna replace the trinket this time around. I'm probably going to use... what can I use? I'll use the Engineer trinket. That's a nice fast cooldown, and that'll give me a lot of easy ground and pound opportunities for Nangin. Hit that guy down. Quick and easy edge, just like that. Just so simple. So simple. So fresh and so clean. Okay, my stalker's back here again. He's lagging. I can't hit him once at all. So, you know, DJ, I hate down talking you, bro, but, you know, fix that lag and stop stalking me, and I won't do it. So let's hit Sorakai down. No luck there. Let's go ahead and pop that trinket. That should... Alright, beautiful stuff here. That should be an edge. Easy, quick edge. Oh, try to steal that kill there. Oh, whoa, look out, Titan Armor. Didn't quite get the opportunity to steal that kill, though. Oh, look out, look out, look out! Maybe I should have went for a Tiger Tail trinket. Oh, got Tau Armor, or Tau, or Guan Yu weapon skilled. Oh, man, nice hit there. Oh, a Hakuman kicked. That's the good strategy there. Let's go ahead and try to get one of these guys with a trinket. Good thing for Gato Kutch there. Oh! Almost got something there going. Let's go ahead and pop this weapon skill. This should hit a lot of these guys. Oh! Okay, I don't know what to say about that. That was just like pure lag or something there. I don't know. I don't know what to say about that. Let's pop the armor. Better than nothing. Pop the helmet. No jumping allowed, no Gato Clutching allowed. You know, it shuts down Gato Clutch, guys. It's really good. Alright, let's pop this trinket in just a second. Be nice to get that off. And it did edge him, so good stuff there. Good trinket. It's becoming one of my more favorite trinkets. I know it's OP, though. Alright, good edge there with the whole D. Oh, Zalyun Helmet got me! Ouch! So yeah, you don't really need to replace the defaults, guys. You know, the trinket's kind of underwhelming, but, you know, the other gears, especially versus, like, ranged players and all that, it really works out nicely sometimes. Oh, almost poisoned. Let's go ahead and pop this trinket. Had to watch out for the Guan Yu, of course. Getting a little bit surrounded here. Oh, nice hold D there. Nice hold D by SBO. Alright, so we can pop the weapon skill here. We're getting pretty surrounded. He's got a recovery item, so that's why I went straight into that basis there. So, you see, if I do like the hold D, he's gonna kind of recover out of it. So, that kind of works against me sometimes. Actually got the good juggle there. That was fun. Ooh, look out. So what I should probably be doing a little bit more than what I'm doing is the inputs off my basics, guys. I know I'm doing a lot of pressure, but if I can do my inputs a little bit more often, that could be a lot nicer. Oh, look out! Oh, the Striker Trinket! That hurts. I should have used that. That would have been a cool gear to use. Oh, look out. At least I did hit her. Pressure off. Good pressure mechanics. Tried to hit Loke there, but I was hitting the wrong person instead. Let's go ahead and pop this helmet, because, you know, I want to avoid something. Oh, well, it got beaten off me already, so whatever. Oh, no, not my stalker! Oh, no! Whoa! Alright, pop the weapon skill. Good stuff there. Tried to keep it simple, but I forgot that there's like a barricade there. There we go, keep it simple. Almost. Getting close to the victories. Let's go and pop the trinket. I should be using it a little bit more than what I am. I kind of messed up there. I should have turned. Uh-oh. I was afraid he had something there. Oh! Look out for the Hakumen. Alright. Oh, yes. Could have had an edge there. I was more worried about Lemur or Sorokai with his Gato Cut. Oh, nice job, Slaco. Uh-oh, horns. This could be a death. Oh! Loke almost got me with his, Rachel. Oh crap! Striker armor, will this edge me? Not quite. Almost edged by Titan armor. No, I'm still okay, guys. So let's pop this armor. Try to get a little bit safe-ish. This time we're gonna start doing, inputs a little bit more. I saw Full Time earlier. Yeah, Full Time's a really good Nangin himself. If you guys ever see Nangin, or wanna see a good Nangin, watch out for Full Time. He does it pretty good as well. He might even be better at it than me. Like, I hate admitting that, because, you know, I've been waiting for Nangin a long time, and my pride says I want to be the best, but, you know, I gotta say, he might be the best. Of course, there's a lot of people playing Nangin, so it's like a wide-open race here. Let's go ahead and pop the weapon skill if I can. There we go. Good stuff. Oh. Uh-oh. It's going... Oh, man, nice. Desperado armor, whoever did that. Hit DJ. There we go. Almost. Just trying to get him. Try to knock him out of the air. Uh-oh. Had to use that trinket to get a little bit of safety there. Oh, so close. So close. Doing well, though. We're hanging in there. Oh, that could have been a kill on Lemur. Almost a kill, at least. Hit the Monkey King. Good stuff. Oh, try to knock him out of the air. Oh, we got the trinket ready, so we can use that. There we go. Oh, he did fall off, at least. Alright, awesome. Oh, that whole D delayed reaction, that worked out nicely. Oh, let's use this armor. No more Gato Clutching. Oh, poor guy. I'm, like, shutting down his whole Gato Clutch mechanic. Look at he tried to jump up there, even. Almost. Let's use this trinket. Just use the armor, the weapon skill. That should kill him if I can... Oh, almost got him. Almost. Oh, he tried to use his trinket to kill him. It looked like it only hit me, though. Phew. Let's see, get that, trying to get that Monkey King again. He's getting a little bit frustrated. Some of you don't let up. Alright, hit Yusuke. Jump canceled that. Could have, input dashed out. Uh-oh, look out, Seiko. Lost my helmet at some point. I don't know where it went. I see someone else's helmet, though, so I'm going to grab that. Let's go ahead and pop this. That should kill... No, Sligo actually ended up with more health. Oh, no! Poison! Poison! It's okay. We can use inputs and stuff to get out of this poison. Here we go. Had to get a little bit of freedom there. Oh, no! Striker... Or what? That's a B-boy armor. Pardon me. Oh, almost. Oh, look out for the Titan. There we go. Oh, so close. There we go. Whoa, look out. Okay, so I was worried about that skill there. Let's see. Okay, yeah, he went right into that. Oh, knocked him out of the air. Oh, no. Let's go ahead and pop this weapon skill. A lot of people here for it. Oh, beautiful. It even shut down that horn. Okay, so let's see. Almost. Let's go ahead and pop the armor. Ruined some people's days. I think I stole a kill with it too, so you know, if you want to start stealing kills in a deathmatch, that's one way to do it. Uh-oh, what just hit me? I think it was a T-60. Okay, oh, let's pop the helmet. Should be A-okay from range attacks now. Go ahead and input out of that. Need to work on the inputs a little bit. Oh, nice job, Slako! Alright, good stuff there. So yeah, Wanderer, guys, you know, what can I say? It's a fun character to play, you know, it's very versatile. You don't have to worry about annoying deflects, annoying Viking shields. You can gap close people who try to play keep away with you. You can knock airborne jumper spammers out of the air pretty easily. It's just really good. It is really good. So let's go to HQ and discuss a few things before ending the video here, guys. So just to cover a few things before ending the video here, guys, with Wanderer. So Wanderer, very good offensive character. You know, you use your whole D, that's your main source of power pretty much, and you go into a nice little combo and do some good damage and potentially edge people quite easily as well. It's very, very good, very, very good. If you're worried about being blocked on your whole D, which you can be blocked and punished, you gotta remember, you can do your input dashing off of your whole D, so you can set yourself up in an easier position to edge that way, or you can do a back dash to keep yourself from being punished too hard if someone does happen to block it. So remember, you can input dash off the whole D. It's one of the things I didn't do too much in the video, but you know, I gotta get used to input dashing. Input dashing can be pretty important. You know, it's a little bit tricky to learn on Nangin since it changes direction, like down, maybe back here, and down will be like a left dash there, so it changes direction. You gotta be kind of on your toes about how you use your inputs, but you can use them off the dashers, you know, off your basics, any part of your basics, and you got jump cancels on your basics as well, so a lot of tools to keep him safe and to keep the pressure up and do some good damage. So yeah, he does do offense very, very well. His jump attack is great anti-air for a lot of airborne-based characters. It's got a very good hitbox, very good horizontal hitbox, and that makes it easy to anti-air people. I mean, the whole D alone is pretty good anti-air, but you gotta time the whole D and to get airborne. With this attack, you don't really have to do much timing. You just gotta kind of be in the general vicinity, and it can knock people out. So yeah, your jump attack, good anti-air pretty much, and it's pretty good ground pressure as well. You can put a half feint on someone and go into some pressure mechanics there. Other things, you know, your counter works out pretty decently. You know, you can't throw it out a whole lot since the startup is a little bit slow, but generally it's really good and it keeps you safe, unlike a lot of counters, so you can't be punished too severely off of it. So it can be nice, it can be really nice to land that nice counter attack once in a while. It doesn't have a guard breaker mechanic, however, so I thought it did way back when, but you know, when it was released in Korea. But I don't think it does have a guard breaker mechanic. I think it might break ice though, but I'm not going to test it here. Your skills, your weapon skill is one of the better in the game. I'd say it's one of the best in the game personally. You know, it's such a good area effect, and you can strip people's gears at low health, and gives you plenty of time to set up stuff off that nice feint too. It's got good hitbox on it too, even up in, towards the air. So good weapon skill there, good weapon skill. Your armor, it's good for fighting things like destroyers and stuff, but it's hard to really capitalize off this without the right kind of gears. You know, I think a fun gear to use with that is actually to use your, if you bought the legendary, let's see if I can find it here, where is it? There it is, figure skating helmet. So this is what I call like the Taku special. You use the armor and then you use the figure skating helmet, which can be pretty darn fun. It can be fun to use that figure skating helmet with that armor. It's pretty neat to do that. You know, you can find some better combinations with the armor, but you generally you're probably gonna have to use skills to use the armor correctly, because it will screw up your combo capability unless you're on the very max distance possible for the basics, which can be really hard to achieve. Even you know, you can kind of get through it in lag once in a while, but you know, it's very hard to get any basic ground hits to the 3-hitter or 4-hitter, whatever it is, after that. So yeah, your armor is very good anti-air and can really ruin a runner's day too. Your helmet, I took the helmet off. There we go. Your helmet's good for those people who play ranged characters. You know, you got your Zolofts on the server, you know, good ranged players, primarily. This is something to shut them down. It also shuts down a lot of important skills like Ice Mage, Ice Shards off its weapon skill, and, you know, Devil Ranger weapon skill. And it'll be very invaluable for, like, sudden attack eventually as well. So, it's a situational gear, but it does work, and it does go away if you get knocked down too. So, try to stay on your feet if you use that. Your trinket, pretty decent gear there. It pops people up into the air and puts a little stun on them. It's a ground lifter as well. It's pretty much a 360 skill too, so it's pretty nice, but you know, I think there's better you could pick, and personally, I think you can do a little bit better in that one. So yeah, for stats, I would go with weapon skill and a skill of your choice. You don't have to keep the default armors if you don't like. I would go for more offensive stuff, personally, as tempting as it is to keep the armor on and disrupt people non-stop. You know, strength is an excellent option on Wanderer as well. You could probably go defense too, because he does tend to die quite a bit, because he is, you know, rushing into the thick of things often with his whole D. So, you know, you can end up taking a lot of damage if you're not careful. So defense can kind of compensate for that, but generally I would go with weapon skill and skill of choice and strength. That would be my two options, go-tos. So yeah, that'll do it for Wanderer here, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and I thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time.